Ajay, congratulations for your success in UPSC Indian Forest Service.
Thank you, sir.
So Ajay has completed his BTech in biotechnology from CET. Then he worked in MNC. Then he left the job with the passion to prepare for administrative services, especially forest service, and prepare for forest service examination. And in this year also, he cleared first the Odisha forest service examination. And then again, he is able to achieve his own dream option of joining Indian Forest Service, securing 24th rank in All India basis. So great pride for the state, because he's the only candidate from Odisha this year to clear the Indian Forest Service examination. So Ajay, so how this journey started?
Actually, my father was already in State Forest Services.
Yeah.
So he inspired me to serve the people, take up public service. So I was already inclined towards public services. And after joining the private sector, it became clear to me that this is not something I want to do. And that's why I left the job and started preparing for civil services examinations.
So your education is in biotechnology.
Yes.
So that is also an emerging sector,
yes,
in not only in India but around the world.
Yes.
But after completing the education over there, so what led you to think about this forest service?
Actually, biotechnology also has multiple applications in forest services, such as in plant breeding, yeah, captive breeding, and wildlife management and environmental engineering.
That will be definitely coming to.
Yes. So I can use my domain knowledge in forest services also. And moreover, I realized that research line is not what attracted me. And
you are in the public domain.
Yeah, because I wanted to go
into the state.
Yes, I wanted to. He was my inspiration from since childhood, and he always, inculcated that value of public service.
Yeah, yeah.
So
you have taken done a course in biotechnology. So here the exam process starts. So you have a total different approach and optionals in this examination. What are your optionals?
My options were zoology and forestry.
Okay.
Zoology, because there were some overlapping domains between biotechnology and zoology, okay, especially in paper 2. And forestry, because it would help me in forest services, and the subject also appealed to me.
So, in which year you start this preparation?
I started this preparation in 2015.
Okay.
And I have been preparing since then. And I have went till different stages of different examinations, such as I have written mains in civil services, in Indian civil services and Odisha civil services. I have appeared in Odisha forest services also once. And I have appeared in this was my third interview at Indian Forest Services.
Okay. So, this year also is a year of double achievement for you. So,
yes.
First you cleared the Odisha Forest Service and then this examination or Indian Forest Service. So on an average, so how do the exam preparation strategy that you have adopted?
It's all about recognizing the needs of the examination process. Like, what is the requirement in prelims examination, main stage and interview stages? So different stages has different requirements. So we need to meet the requirement of each stage to get to the service finally. So what took me this long, because I was not so good at writing answers. So that is the reason why I used to clear prelims of every examination.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
But at main stage, I used to falter. So gradually I developed that habit of writing answers, and it took some time, and thankfully I finally reached to that stage where I could secure a service.
So that means, so you very well want to say to the aspirant that writing is very important in this examination,
yes,
because your ranks and your ultimate success depend upon your level of writing.
Yes.
Because you are appearing the same preliminary examination.
Yes.
But the main examination is completely subjective.
Yes.
Where you have to develop your writing skill a lot.
Yes.
Achieve perfection.
Yes.
So, on an average, how many hours? So there is a common query. So among the beginners, so how many hours in a day, for how long, that can lead to success?
On an average, it's all about consistency. This whole exam process is about consistency. So I would say that consistently studying about 8 to 10 hours per day is enough to crack these examinations. But one thing I would focus is on consistency. It's not about you study 13 to 14 hours one day and you take rest for 3 to 4 days. Then it may not work out. As being a college engineering student, what we were habituated in studying the day before the exam
and mug up everything, and the approach is completely different.
Yes, here the approach is completely different because it takes some time to develop all the skills of the three stages, especially the main stage, the prelim stage. So consistency is the key. If you study for 8 to 10 hours per day, every day, then
that means adding bricks every day.
Yes, to your infrastructure. Improving day by day, finally will lead to success.
So what is the importance of optional in this examination?
Yes, optional is a key factor in this examination because your marks in the optionals will determine because almost everyone will secure
GS paper
if you you can improve up to a certain level.
Yeah.
But choosing a right optional and securing marks in good marks in the optional is key to securing a good rank.
Yeah, yeah.
So we should choose optional carefully. We should identify our strengths and weaknesses and our interest, first of all. That matters the most. What is our interest and which optionals appeal to us the most and which optional we would like to study the most. We can study for hours and we won't get bored.
Yeah, yeah.
So
because you are from biotechnology.
Yes.
But you have taken botany and
zoology and forestry.
Zoology and forestry.
Yes.
So and forestry is also there in part of forestry might have read in your academics. So some in both the parts, zoology and forestry, have some link with what you have read in your
graduation period.
So for the aspirants who are preparing for this examination, what will be your Nobel Lines to them?
I have three values which I inculcated during my this preparation phase, which I hope that the values would help the aspirants also. First is the famous Sanskrit quote, ancient quote, Karmanye Vadhikaraste Ma Phaleshu Kadachana. We should focus on what we can control. We can control our preparation. We can control how much we can study, how much we can put in the effort. But the results, they are not in our hands. Yeah. So if we focus on the result, it will cause tension and anxiety and will hamper our exam process and it will create a negativity inside us.
Yeah.
So we should focus on the process. Second is to see each failure as not as a failure, but as a learning experience.
Yeah, one step towards success.
Yes. We should learn from the failure. One of my friend who is in IAS right now, he used to say, never waste a good crisis.
Yeah, yeah.
If you are failing, if you are affected by it, then focus on what you can learn from that thing and improve upon that. See each failure as a learning experience. And third, I would say have a growth mindset. Continuously learning. Initially I was not able to even complete the
answer writing. Yeah.
In the mains examination, yeah. I would hardly finish half of the questions in the mains examination.
Okay.
So I decided that no, I would not give up. I would learn from it. I would learn answer writing. I would try to do the best I can. In the writing segment. So I worked upon it year after year and finally I got to where I am today.
Okay. So we are so happy that you are with us and some way Banik was in your preparation process to some extent. And you are getting hopefully you'll be in the state cadre. So many aspirants are there in the state who are preparing for this. And the number of achievers in this examination is comparatively very less from the state. So our association and our mentoring and your own support to the students in times to come will definitely bring more success in the Indian Forestry Examination from the state of Odisha. Thank you. Thank you for it.
Thank you.